good to see you. Thank you so much for being here. One more time, a round of applause for our winner.
Thank you very much.
Because this is the last night of Christmas sweaters, we want to go out with a bang. So please welcome, for a very special performance, the Radio City Rockettes!
We started the Christmas sweater tradition probably back in late night, so probably I'd say 12 years ago, something like that, or at least 11 years ago.
Bring out the Countdown to Christmas cabinet. Bring it on up.
12 days of Christmas sweater, 12 days
left. It's just kind of grown over the years and become one of like the bits that people like love, and it reminds them of this time of year. Our wardrobe department, our costume department, gosh, I love that whole team. Mario is a genius, and he actually puts in a year's or more time into making every single sweater.
Every year we do 12 days of Christmas sweaters, and every year the sweaters become more and more elaborate. The interesting part about it is all these sweaters did not start out as Christmas sweaters. This was just a white sweater, but it inspired me to make this into a cowboy Christmas sweater. So it comes from all different places.
Whoa. No, man, wow, look at that.
This is kind of where the cat sweater started. I try to do really quick, rough sketches, and so I can lay out in my mind what's going to be on the sweater. I definitely wanted yarn just spread out all over the sweater like a cat was playing.
People are so excited because now it's become a thing. They're like, oh my gosh, I'm getting one of these one-of-a-kind sweaters. And I think throughout the years, they've become more elaborate and more beautiful. That actually, as silly as they are and crazy as they are, they actually look good.
Sometimes people are shy and they don't, but other times, like, someone will do like a handstand. They're so excited to like win this like piece of art that it's kind of great.
We always love for the last four or five sweaters to be really over the top and the most amazing. So we save those to be the ones that light up. The biggest challenge is, how's this sweater going to fit into a box?
You know, we didn't get to do this last year, obviously, because there were no audiences. And the fact that we get to do it and see my audience and see the reaction, see the way people just celebrate, and we just want to come together and have fun. And there's something cool about that, showing that, you know, baby steps. We're coming back. We're going to get there, and we will, even if it's just one ugly Christmas sweater at a time.